Hello, my name is Manasa and today we are going to be discussing about high-risk pregnancies. And we have with us today Dr. Jyotsna Madan, Senior Consultant in Obstetrics Gynecology in Manipal Hospitals, Jayanagar. She has over 30 years of experience and her interests include high-risk pregnancies and its challenges. Welcome, Doctor. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you'll answer our queries and questions about high-risk pregnancies. So, Doctor, I'd like to start with knowing what exactly is high-risk pregnancies.
See, coming to the point, all pregnancies fall under high-risk category. We usually never call a patient as low-risk, but we have a terminology called high-risk. The reason is the lady who does not have any other factors other than she being pregnant, she doesn't have any other complications, she though falls under low-risk. Anytime during pregnancy, she may get converted to high risk, like she can develop other complications. But to begin with, she is a low risk, but still we never label. But a patient, when she is coming to me for the first time to the hospital in the beginning of her pregnancy, I always have that habit of writing HRP, that is high risk pregnancy, because in the beginning itself, she's fallen under some of the risk categories.
Okay. So, doctor, roughly, what percentage of your patients come under this condition?
Okay, as the years are going by, I think we have been seeing a lot of increase in the incidence of high risk pregnancy. See, I can say three decades back, it was just about 1 to 2%, which became about 10% two decades back, and now I can say 30 to 35% of our patients have one or the other risk factor.
Okay. So, doctor, which patients do you categorize under high-risk pregnancies?
Yes. Recurrent pregnancy loss, which was very less earlier. Now, we see a lot of women having abortions, 1, 2, 3 previous abortions. So, when she has got more than 2 abortions, we call her as a patient with recurrent abortions, and she needs to be tackled in a different way compared to another patient who is just conceived and pregnancy goes smoothly to the term. Then diabetes in pregnancy, which was very, very rare, probably 1% or even less 30 years ago in Indian population, has become now very common. As many as 10 to 15% of our pregnant women we see complicated with diabetes. So obviously that requires special care. Hypertension during pregnancy, anemia during pregnancy, bleeding disorders, like bleeding can be because of the placenta lying low or whatever may be the reason, they come under high risk. And one of the common reason for high risk is previous cesarean scar. Earlier, the primary C-section rate was low, so the recurrent cesarean section rate was also low. But now, because of all these risk factors, there's been a tremendous increase in the incidence of cesarean section. So this patient who is already has a scar, when she comes to me next time, I will obviously label her as high risk pregnancy and put the cause for high risk factor being previous C-section. And to enumerate one more thing, in vitro fertilization. Lot of infertility, lot of late marriages, late conceptions leading to assisted reproductive techniques, treatment with in vitro fertilization. So she's a woman at 38 and conceived after 15 years of marriage. I would not want to treat her like I'm going to treat a woman who is 28 year old, married just 6 months back, and she's had a spontaneous conception, right? So IVF conception also comes under high risk category.
Okay, so doctor, why do you think there has been a surge in incidence of cesarean rate? A lot of people have been talking about how there's an increase in cesarean sections. So why do you think that is, doctor?
Recurrent pregnancy loss, which was very less earlier. Now we see a lot of women having abortions, 1, 2, 3 previous abortions. So when she has got more than 2 abortions, we call her as a patient with recurrent abortions, and she needs to be tackled in a different way compared to another patient who is just conceived and pregnancy goes smoothly to the term. Then diabetes in pregnancy, which was very, very rare, probably 1% or even less 30 years ago in Indian population, has become now very common. As many as 10 to 15% of our pregnant women we see complicated with diabetes. So obviously that requires special care. Hypertension during pregnancy, anemia during pregnancy, bleeding disorders, like bleeding can be because of the placenta lying low or whatever may be the reason, they come under high risk. And one of the common reason for high risk is previous cesarean scar. Earlier, the primary C-section rate was low, so the recurrent cesarean section rate was also low. But now, because of all these risk factors, there's been a tremendous increase in the incidence of cesarean section. So this patient who is already has a scar, when she comes to me next time, I will obviously label her as high risk pregnancy and put the cause for high risk factor being previous C-section.
Okay.
And to enumerate one more thing, in vitro fertilization. Lot of infertility, lot of late marriages, late conceptions leading to assisted reproductive techniques, treatment with in vitro fertilization. So she is a woman at 38 and conceived after 15 years of marriage. I would not want to treat her like I am going to treat a woman who is 28 year old, married just 6 months back, and she has had a spontaneous conception, right? So IVF conception also comes under high risk category.
So doctor, why do you think there is an increase in diabetic pregnant women these days?
Okay. See, first of all, that our ancestors being diabetic, the incidence was very less. So their next generation, the coming generation and all that developing genetic predisposition of diabetes was less three generations ago. Now for the last 20 years, diabetes has become common in India. In fact, in another one decade, probably it will be number one. India will be number one in number of diabetic patients. So obviously, if she is a girl born to a diabetic parents, she has more genetic predisposition. Another reason could be obesity, lifestyle modifications, eating habits. Lot of them get involved into eating junk food. And BMI, which should normally be 18 to 25, many of our patients we see morbidly obese with a BMI of 30 and so. So that itself becomes a high risk factor for them to develop diabetes during pregnancy.
So doctor, are all obstetricians or all hospitals equipped with dealing with such high risk pregnancies?
Yeah, I think so. Most of us most of the hospitals have facilities except for the small nursing homes where they do not have NICU care or to arrange if there is any bleeding or to arrange anything in cases of emergency ICU if they do not have. Otherwise, most of the hospitals do have, at least at present.
Doctor, have you come across a lot of patients that require assisted reproductive treatment?
That is again is on the increase. Same reasons apply to that also. Lifestyle modification, nobody gets involved into physical activity, everybody is sitting at the desk and working for hours together, and their late sleeping hours, late waking up hours, everything is adding on to their obesity. So when they are obese, they have a common condition called as polycystic ovarian disease, which we see at least in 40 to 50% of our young girls in the reproductive age group. So this is all increasing. Many of them can respond to simple treatment which we give, but when they fail to respond to simple treatment, they need to go in for either IVF, IUI, that kind of assisted reproductive techniques.
Okay.
Basically, it's a lifestyle and the obesity which has led to so many other factors, either before she conceives or during conception and even postnatally.
So doctor, what exactly is a high dependency unit and how is it used?
High dependency unit is a place where it is equipped well to handle a patient. Suppose there can be something called as amniotic fluid embolism, she just like that collapses, or there is a case of bleeding, she can go into shock anytime, there she has to be revived. So having all the facilities available in a waiting area where patient is in labor, she is in waiting period, and she has everything available. And the ICU is very close by, just in case we need to shift her, or operation theatre is just close by in the same floor, we need to shift her. That is what is called as high dependency unit. And with facilities being available for monitoring both the mother and the fetus.
So doctor, what exactly is high dependency unit and how is it used?
Like I mentioned earlier, obesity is the leading cause for PCOS. And PCOS patients invariably will have many of the other autoimmune conditions like hypothyroidism and diabetes. So all of them put together, she obviously when she conceives, either by chance naturally or with a simple ovulation induction or with IVF, she is going to fall under high risk category. So obviously when she's been trying for pregnancy for many years and not being able to conceive due to her PCOS, she would have probably been an elderly gravida also. So age above 35 years is again another risk factor.
Okay, so doctor, in case of an emergency, is the hospital equipped with a blood bank?
See, there There are certain criteria for the blood bank to be available in all the hospitals. It has to fulfill the availability of the blood bank should be fulfill the required prerequisites are there. So the hospital has to fulfill all those prerequirements, only then blood bank can be run. However, in our hospital Malti Manipal, though it doesn't have a blood bank of its own, it has a parent hospital Main Manipal from where they organize blood. But just in case, due to distance, we are dire need of blood, it's in minutes to, like, you know, within half an hour we need to arrange blood, we can always get it from nearby blood banks. So not all the hospitals are equipped with blood bank, but definitely they have tie up with some of the blood banks and it can be brought immediately.
Okay, so doctor, in case of emergencies, do you have a blood bank or are there any other precautions taken for that?
Many times we are consultants may not be available all the time to deliver a patient. So from the time of admission to delivery, so we have our junior consultants who are registrars and they are all well equipped with high risk pregnancy and what has to be done, because high risk pregnancy has to be monitored more closely compared to otherwise a patient who does not have high risk factors. I don't call it as low risk. Okay, so the junior doctors are aware and our nurses and the labor room other staff, they are all definitely aware of this. That's the reason many times we insist that they should not shift labor room staff or hospital, I mean operation theater staff, to other places on rotation. Right. So usually they continue working in the same area so that they are aware, they would have gained knowledge by that.
So doctor, are all your staff members and nurses equipped with dealing with such high risk pregnancies?
Yes, and I think your question has been answered about the cesarean section rate being high. That's because primary C-section rate, due to all these risk factors being high, this lady at the age of 38, if she is giving birth to her first child, when she comes back with the previous cesarean scar at the age of 40, obviously she is going to be under high risk category.
So doctor, in COVID times, what are all the precautions you take in dealing with such high risk pregnancies?
See, this is a pandemic which has affected whole world, and obviously it has affected many of our pregnant women. And we need to be, we being medical and medical personnel or those who are working at the hospital, they are more at risk of contacting the disease. So we take utmost precautions, wearing PPE kits during delivery or outpatient, wearing double mask with shield and things like that, changing the gown, gloves every time we see a patient. And definitely this patient, our obstetric patients, when they conceive, when they or who are already pregnant, if they have contacted the disease, it can easily be treated. And later on she can be delivered. But sometimes we are doing COVID-19 tests for all of them at term, just before delivery. Suppose if they turn out to be positive, then in such cases we need to take even more extra precautions than a COVID negative mother. During delivery, all the hospital staff should be informed, she should be in isolation room.
Thank you so much, doctor, for throwing some light on our queries and doubts about high-risk pregnancy.
Manasa, you asked me some few questions about high-risk pregnancy. Even one day, if it is given, it's not just enough to clarify all the doubts about high-risk pregnancy, because 30% of our population is come under this category of high-risk pregnancy, and each high-risk pregnant patient is different from the other one. So any doubts anybody has regarding this, they can contact the hospital, Manipal Hospital, Jayanagar, at the given number. Thank you.
If you have any doubts or questions regarding high-risk pregnancies, please contact the number given below. Thank you.